Hello guys and welcome to another video. Today we are here doing a tint install by SOLARPLEXIUS. This tint over here is very high quality. I already did install tints like this on other of my customers' cars over here. Okay, this video is being proudly sponsored by SOLARPLEXIUS. With these tints over here, you can have an excellent UV protection. You can also have a great look to your car. Here on this video today, we are doing installing on a 156 SW and Alfa Romeo, which is very simple to do, except here on the boot lid I choose to do a small disassemble so it will be easier to install over here. Okay, so on this video we are doing the back window, we are doing the side window, and also we are doing there the side door window. Okay, on the side windows, if you are using this product over here, you may not want to lower or raise the glass because it can scratch the tint over here, but on this case the AC is performing beautifully, as you know by now, and in that way it is no need to open or close the doors. Okay, you can do it, yes, but it is preferred not to do so. You can also only purchase the back one and the side one and skip the windows of the doors. Okay, if you want to, you can choose that. Okay, so today with this video over here, you have a 15% discount with my code, with my discount code BrunoAlfa15. You go to solarplexius.com or that whatever country you are in, okay, choose the product that you want. You have several options to do so, and then you insert my discount code BrunoAlfa15 and you get 15% off of all of your purchases. Okay, so thank you very much for SOLARPLEXIUS. They were impeccable with everything so far, and I hope in the future as well, because I am trying to purchase a new car, not so new, a Julia, and I want also to install these tints on it, okay? But that will be for the near future, okay? So let's go here, start with the back window, installing here the solar tint, get the car really pretty. The added benefit that I'm seeing here on these tints will be, because these cars are starting to get old, okay, this is a 156, the plastics on the inside are starting to be a little bit eaten away by the sun, my assumption here is I will be able to save or to retard a little bit the wear and tear on the plastics. So this window here will be protected along with the other side. On this side over here is more to my son. My young son is 4 years old at this stage, and in this way I want to protect him. The car has the perfectly functioning AC, and this car has AC also here on the back to the feet into the face, okay, and everything is working perfectly, so there is no need to open the window. If you are trying to figure out if you want also the back doors, if you are using constantly the back doors, probably is not the best idea. Just do the back window and the back. So again, here on this side, my plastics, as I now do not have, these are my garages, but are being used here right now for the workshop. And for that, my car does not have a garage. So the sun is trying to eat away my car. So I, in this way, I want to solve a bunch of issues that are appearing on this car, which are age. Okay, try to retard the problems on plastics, try to retard here this peeling of these plastics over here, also here on this area, and here on this back door, as you can see, this is very well constructed from my experience, and if I remove here this black area over here, it will be very easy to install this tint. Okay, so down in the description will be a video for the removal and installing of this black area over here. If you want to see that, it is down in the description, so you to understand how it's done, okay? Now this is the most important paper you have over here. This is a printing of the law. We have here gloves and we also have here some shims. These ones on this card, normally they are not needed, but depends really on the card that you may have, okay? The shims help out you to have a perfect fitment and for the tint not to be rattling about, okay? So you have here several instructions how to do that. You also have here a QR code to do the assembly. Okay, this is a general assembly, not a model by model guide, but it is quite truthful, okay? Okay. And this over here is the most important thing. It also depends really on the country that you may have, because on some countries like Portugal, it is illegal to have tinting if it is not legalized. So you, if you do not have tinting tints from factory, and you have, if you want to have them, you have to do a special inspection and try to legalize everything. That always goes around €1,000 to do that, and with the legal fees and the installing and whatnot, the ones that are glued into the window, okay? This ones being mobile, well, they are an accessory, they are not permanent. In this way, here is the law that says not being permanent, it can be used at all times, okay? Over here on this back one, we have here a stamp that should be facing outwards. Well, when you are looking to the car, outside the car, you should be able to read this. It looks like a very, very dark tint, and from the outside in is, but from the inside out is very, very nice. So you also can install it as is, and then after installing, remove the back layer. The seal over here facing outwards. Ta-da! Now we can assemble here this plate, this black plate. Down in the description will be a video for that. In the meantime, you can remove here the film. My white trim over here is really, really starting to flake, and I really want to try to save this. Now just repeat the steps over here, on this side one. I probably will take out the film on both sides because it can be a little bit tricky to remove the film without damaging my trim. Like I said, the trim on my car, these bezels over here around the glass on the inside are very, very fragile. So I'll try to do like this. You have to have good nails too. Or something to take out the film. Small blade, probably. Remembering again, stamp out. and you already can see the difference between on and off. It has this mirror-like effect. It's very nice. You can see clearly that it has some distance, not so clearly, but you can see that it has some distance between the glass and the tint, but it is not ugly. It is quite nice, actually. Quite nice. Okay, you can see here, still without and with. So if you decide with not having the door, with the back door with the tint, this is the difference. And it is quite nice. It is still quite nice, okay? You can see also in the sun in a minute, okay? This side doors are a little bit tougher to do because you want to install the tint where the glass works. So on the inner window scraper, on the channel ways over here, up here where the glass meets the rubber, it all has to be flush, okay? So that's why if you are using the glass, the function of raising and lowering the glass, it's not a good idea to do so, okay? So in your case, you may want to not have this door being done, okay? Do not forget, again, the seal facing outwards. Now, through there, the inner window scraper. In that way, you can create more space to insert the tint. Make sure that the tint goes all the way into the window scraper. Sometimes that is not easy. As it is flexible, you can manage to do some experimenting. Now I will try to pass it through these grooves over here and finally here, up here. I think we are close. So I like to leave the tint almost in place over here on top, then when the glass raises, it will catch it. This will do a bit of a force on the window regulator, so try to help out. If you see there is too much, you may want to lower down a bit the tint. You want to adjust as much as you can. Turn on the car if necessary, so you have 14 volts instead of 12. And so guys, here we have it. The final result of the install. As you can see over here, the factory window has a little bit of, not a tint, but it has something. Okay, so it has some color, and you can see the difference between open and closed. But here you have the tints, okay? Very nice final result. It is really easy to do. So for the 156SW, you have here how it's done, okay? Down in the description, you will have more social media links for SOLARPLEXIUS. Also down in the description, you will have my code, my discount code, which is BRUNOALFA15. It is also down in the description if you want to copy that, okay? And if you are new to the channel because of the work that I did over here, I work on Alfa Fiat in Lancia, and I try to do all things in all areas of the car, like crank no start, like brakes, suspension, very difficult diagnosis, troubleshooting solutions, and much more, okay? Check out down in the description everything that I have for you. I have several links for many videos that can and will be useful for you, okay? I see you on the next one, guys. Bye!